Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. My name is Sean Capapiano. I am the band director here at New Oxford High School, and we are so glad that you're here for our spring concert this afternoon. The first piece, Chant and Jubilo, is one of the band standards. It's just one of those pieces that we really try to expose everybody to at some point while we're here at the high school. And it's become a favorite of mine. I'm hoping that it's more of a favorite of theirs than when we started on that journey. We're moving on to Amparito Roca, which is a Spanish march. It's one of the first Spanish marches ever written for band, and it's just a lot of fun to get into, and it challenges them in some neat and unique ways. There is some audience participation involved, so hopefully you get to enjoy this piece as much as we do. This is Amparito Roca. It is always a pleasure during the spring concert to take an opportunity to recognize our senior class and those of us who are sharing the stage with our ensemble for the last time in their schooling career. It's certainly bittersweet, and it's certainly extra bittersweet this year because this is the first senior class that I've spent all 4 years with. So it's extra emotional for me at this point because of that special connection that we have. But in addition to that, we get to offer a little bit of money, which is always really great, and help sponsor the furthering of their education through the Band Booster program. For those of you who are unaware, the Band Booster program sponsors $1,000 in scholarship money to help a band senior who's been a member of the program for 4 years in furthering their pursuits in any degree. It does not have to be a degree in music, but it's in recognition of the dedication they put into this program and hopefully helping them reach their next goals in that next stage of life. So without further ado, I'm going to invite our current Booster president, Mr. Tom McPheeters, to come up to the stage and present what is now named the Tom McPheeters Bring On the Band Scholarship.
Good evening. No, I'm not looking at my notes, just give you guys a 15-minute speech. I gotta figure out who I'm giving this award to. Somewhere in my text messages here. Okay, I got it now. I'm trying to stall also. Mr. C's bringing out someone. All right, like Mr. C said, it is an honor for the New Oxford Band Boosters to give out a $1,000 scholarship to one individual or $500 out to two individuals. This year we decided to do two individuals. With that, I'm going to make this name on them coming out. How are we doing this? That's good. I'm running the show, right? Okay, I'm running the show. What I was going to have you guys do is stand up one more time and give these guys a round of applause just to let them know how much. Stand up and give them a round of applause. And to be honest with you, that's the first time I ever got a standing ovation. So thank you. You're all so gentlemen. Had to get one way or another. Okay. It is my honor as the Band Booster President to give out two scholarships this year for the New Oxford Band Boosters. The first one's going to go to Ariana Jafrida, and the second one, Eliza Vargas.
Parents, we're going to make sure that you have a chance to take a picture with the big check after the concert. We had to make sure that, you know, we got our money's worth out of the bigcheckstore.com today. So we will certainly make sure that's available after the concert. But if we can have one more round of applause, not only for these two, but for our entire team. Just give us about 10 seconds. We're going to take another tuning note for our band, and then we'll get into our third piece here. So this past summer, as I was finishing my master's degree, I had the opportunity to study with the composer of this piece, Julie Giroux. She is one of the greats of our time as far as band composers are concerned. She's a master orchestrator, has worked for a number of movies that you've probably seen as the film score conductor, and she just writes in a way that's really important that we introduce to our students. This piece, I'm gonna try not to cry. but I will probably cry, so bear with me. It has a lot of emotional significance for me because I'm an animal lover, as probably are many of you and our students. The term "our castaways" is written in honor and memory of companion animals, adopted animals, who have had second chances throughout the world. So I'm gonna read the program note to get us started. That's why we have a little bit of an extra multimedia piece to this, and then we will be off. 6.5 million companion animals enter animal shelters every year, and 2.4 million of these adoptable animals are put down. These numbers do not include the thousands who suffer in silence. Thanks to thousands of caring people, these numbers are steadily decreasing, but we still have a long way to go. This work is dedicated to those who work hard in the fight to end puppy mills, to rescue suffering pets, and provide care and medical attention to all those rescued. We are all shepherds. Every little creature is in our care. Hopefully mankind will someday uphold his responsibility and become caretaker of all living things. Maybe someday all humans will be humane and all mankind will be kind.
Thank you.
And as they say, now time for something completely different. The final piece on our program is a piece that was just published this year by a very famous band composer at this point for schools, Mr. Randall Standridge, entitled Affirmation. The program notes are as such. Every once in a while, I believe you get to say something with a piece of music. When I was in high school, I was definitely not one of the popular crowd. My taste in music, art, and movies were too weird. I was awkward. Generally, I was that artsy kid. If I could go back in time, I would give that younger me a hug and say, "You are fine the way you are. You are amazing." It would have been easy to write something soft, lyrical, and saccharine, but I wanted to take a different approach. I wanted it to be a celebration. So this is the single happiest thing I've ever written in my career. This one goes out to the band geeks, the nerdy kids, the art kids, the drama kids, the punk rockers, the LGBTQ kids, the kids of color, and all the people, kids and adults, who have ever been made to feel less than because of who they are. You are just fine the way you are. You are worth celebrating. Be 100% you.
Thank you. Remember those days.
Well, she didn't know. Oh, she said it dramatic.
Thursday. And I guess my dad.
I can help us out. Like, you know, keep an eye on her. So then I was out there with Owen. He flew her. My dad, I didn't know she came.
Okay.
He couldn't hear. The next door, she sucked her hair into it. Like, it could have ripped it. It had a huge knot. It wasn't funny at the time. It's not funny. You shouldn't laugh at it. But when I was there, I was trying to, like, get the knot out, and it was just falling out. It was terrible.
And then,
But she was fine. And then yesterday we were outside playing. Now
she's a good mother.
Terrible mother, I am. Sucking her hair up and then.
There you're dying.
Next thing you know, she's falling through the crack.
Good character.
You got a little sunburn.
Yeah. We had fun though, right? We had the bounce house out. We were only out there for like three hours
jumping in a bounce house.
No, I remember Perry being in one of these seats. I don't know if you hear the movie theater, and she sat all the way back, and she went.
It'll be all right.
So I remember those days.
I'm looking over at the candidates. I didn't get the email.
Oh, everybody's stuck on.
Yeah. The first week.
I was good.
Thank you.
Creel, and I am the middle and high school orchestra director here at New Oxford. That first piece, La La Land, was actually our senior choice piece this year. Every year I give my seniors a chance to vote on a piece that they played throughout their high school career that they enjoyed and want to play one last time, and this is the piece that they chose. So this is a perfect time, I think, to acknowledge my seniors. So seniors, go ahead and stand up and give a wave. Congratulations. To me, I don't know if they realized this or thought about this lately, but I started here at New Oxford 6 years ago when they started seventh grade. So they're my first class to see graduate for me to teach the whole way through. So that's been really special for me this year with them. A couple other groups of people that I want to acknowledge before we play our next piece. My orchestra council are people who meet with me during the year and help plan events, help plan concerts, and things that we do in class. And they are just super, super helpful, and I want to acknowledge them real quick. So orchestra council, please stand up. And then finally, some people that I forgot to thank in March, and I am so sorry about that, are the people who went to County Orchestra in November. They auditioned successfully for this group and were chosen and worked really hard and put on a wonderful festival back in November. So County Orchestra participants, please stand. And we had one student who represented us at District 7 Orchestra this past winter. Chloe, go ahead and stand up. And I think that's everyone, so just give us a second and then we'll start with our second piece.
Thank you. way up here.
Thank you.
Testing. Hi, I'm your Stage Change Entertainment. Who's ready for a dad joke? No, I'm just kidding. We're going to take this opportunity during a stage change to recognize some of our musicians that have gone above and beyond extracurricularly. So I'm going to invite them out here in just a moment and we'll explain our process here. So coming out are members of our indoor percussion ensemble. Indoor percussion is an extension of the marching program. The difference is it is all inside in a gymnasium, and it's just drums and mallet instruments. So it's a little bit different. But these students, I'm going to move the mic so you can look at them. These students have gone above and beyond because they have represented their school district very well. Last year, this particular ensemble won their championships in a slightly different division, but with the highest score of the entire day, which consisted of about 30 different schools and organizations from Pennsylvania, Maryland, Virginia, and West Virginia. So that's a huge accomplishment. And then we were back to the ordinary, what we call Scholastic Blue Division this year, and they competed against six other ensembles at the championship level once they qualified for the same honor, and they did it again. And we're very proud of them for that accomplishment. Just as in any other activity, whether it be athletics, academics, or arts, they put a lot of time into their craft and a lot of effort into what they do to do it at such a high level, and we're really proud of them for representing our community in this way. As a result, the Boosters have offered to present them with some championship jackets in commemoration of their accomplishments, and we are going to be presenting the students with them at this time. If you can please help me congratulate our indoor percussion ensemble one more time for their championship jackets. Students, hang tight. We will bring your jackets to you, and then we will move on to the choir portion.
Yeah.
Thank you again. Congratulations to these students. And we will be back with you shortly. That last tune is by a close friend about a close friend, and it's been a journey for us to sing this year, so thank you for listening to it again. We performed that one in March. And now, before we are all standing in a puddle of tears, I'd like to take this moment and acknowledge our seniors. This next piece is The Road Home, what's become our tradition to send off for them. And if you pay close attention to the text, you'll understand why. So before the tears anymore get going, let's acknowledge our concert choir seniors. Thank you. Thank you so much. This year has been a joy and a pleasure, and I wish you all a fantastic summer and hope to see you back here soon. Thank you.
It wasn't gonna go too far. Put you right on it. Good job, light man. You're hired.
Hey, you're still streaming.
Yeah, I know. I'm gonna kill it right here.